Tonight I chose DJ J-Mo, who is a Detroit native, but has lived in St. Louis for the last 20 plus years. And I chose J-Mo because he has a unique ear. He has a very different way of looking at music, and you're gonna see that tonight, and all the people who are here are gonna hear that tonight. And he's one of our dispatchers to the world. He lives in St. Louis, but he travels around the world. He's part of a DJ coalition called the Soulition that's really highly respected in DJ circles. And I just wanted to make certain we brought him here so that people could get a taste of that. And what better time to do it than this time of year when everybody's looking for something cool to do?
So growing up, you know, I kind of played around with my parents' records growing up and broke a lot of them. But at the same time, you know, I had this passion. I always had this passion for music. I grew up in Detroit as a drummer playing in church, and kind of got away from the musician side of it. And when I went away to school, to college in St. Louis, I actually started getting more into, like, you know, DJing and stuff like that. And I was playing for, like, college parties and private parties, and then I started taking it seriously. Started working at a few nightclubs and whatnot. Yeah, that's how I started. So I'm an independent music player first. I play a lot of independent soul music, and then I play a lot of Latin. I have a monthly Latin night called Sofrito. So I do a lot of international music. And I'm a part of a coalition of DJs called the Soulition. And we're known for actually playing international music, independent artists, you know, like Foreign Exchange, Omar, you know, stuff like that. When you have a very small budget and you're making it, you know, from the soul, you know, it's just that you put a little bit more of yourself into it. So, you know, I think that's the difference between the independent soul artists and the, you know, more mainstream, because, you know, I think the radio stations kind of guide them on the sound that they want them to have. Whereas the independent artists, they actually do what they feel. So, you know, and that's what I prefer. I'm known for playing other. And a lot of people say, he's a good DJ, but he kind of plays the other stuff. Which, and I'm okay with that, you know, I'm okay with playing other because there's a crowd for that. Especially my international stuff, the Latin stuff. I'm really into that stuff a lot. And Afrobeat and stuff like that. A lot of the guys in our crew play a lot of these different things, and you kind of, when you're around your peers, you kind of listen and you hear stuff that you like, and you're like, all right, man, you know, okay, I like Four Heroes, drum and bass, all right, so I want to get into drum and bass. So start playing a little drum and bass, and I just have being a percussionist growing up, I kind of have a passion or an ear for, like, drums and snares and, you know, music that has a lot of that, you know, hard snare and congas in it. So that most of the independent artists use a lot of that stuff in the Afrobeat and the Latin. So that's what I love to play.
I really try to mix it up. I also try to get a feel for what the crowd is feeling, what people are responding to. If there's a particular type of groove, I like to try to stick with the audience and make sure that they kind of can continue that groove so that it's not a whole lot of interruption. For this particular event, I really wanted to try to dig into a lot of diasporic music, music from Africa, music with a lot of heavy drums and a lot of soul to it. So really I kind of wanted to sort of revisit that and take people on that sort of down that sort of path for the night. And people seem to be grooving. It's always a good sign when you play something and you see people turn around and look in the direction of the DJ booth. So that's what I always try to go for. You know, I think my musical influence kind of stems from just traveling. I've been to about 14 countries. I had an older cousin that I grew up with that was really into music, and you know, just really sort of following her around helped really sort of broaden my musical interest. And everywhere I go, you know, there's always music. I think it's hard to escape music. So each time I move into a new place or I meet a new person, there always seems to be an opportunity to sort of pull some new music from that experience. So my base is very broad ranging, and I think that gives you a lot of flavor as a DJ. That gives you a lot of flexibility and virtuosity. And so that's something I like to try to maintain.